I thank the Lord for all he has been doing since we come. I thank God for both hearing his word and also spending time to pray, to beef up our spiritual lives. Thank God for our pastors, for the time they spent to pray yesterday, and also for two prayer groups, the prayer teams in the Enugu environment, and the prayer teams from our Nkanu districts, all praying. Those ones prayed till about 5 o'clock this morning, because we want to see the glory of revival. We must give enough attention to prayers. This evening, I'm talking on the subject, taking the revival fire far. One thing you need to know, in that message, there's an assumption that you have the revival fire. Like what we had during the message on healthy lifestyles, that you cannot give what you don't have. It takes a man who has revival fire who can take it far. And that's why every member, every worker, every leader, every pastor should endeavor to make sure that he catches the revival flame. If God says we are all path revival, people who are endowed with all time revival fire, then it will be deception who we don't have revival fire. Listen to me. The picture in my mind is that every section of this church will be carriers of revival fire. Means both possessors, carriers, demonstrators, and projectors of the revival fire. That among our choir, you see, among the choristers, it's not just singing. They are both singing with anointing, and all of them are dynamic preachers. That even as they are singing, healings are taking place. As they are singing, you see sinners crying, people broken. That at times after they sing, the preacher will see no need of coming to preach. That is the picture of a church in my mind. When we talk about all path revival, where everybody is carrying the flame of revival. My picture of ushers, I a people filled with power, that even as they move around the congregation, you will sense the presence, the power, the fire of God in their midst. I have said it before, that when they are helping, whether the blind or the lame, I say, come, let us carry her or carry him. As they are trying to carry the lame like this, just touching the lame or the wheelchair, the person will rise up from the wheelchair. That is, amidst them, you will see fire. That means, not like the ushers I have now, who don't have time for prayers or night vigil. There are ushers that carry fire, and when you see ushers, where they are preaching and praying, you know that these are a revived group. The same thing to among those who are cooking in the kitchen. They see themselves beyond just cooking. They see themselves as revival ambassadors. Before they start to cook every day, when you see them praying to prepare to cook, you say, where are they going for crusade? Yes, the crusade they are doing is the crusade of preparing food for God's own people. You don't see any form of laxities or frivolities in their midst. No room for gossip, no room for carelessness. Even after they finish cooking, even after tiredness, they say, let's just gather together to thank God for a day we have spent. Before, as they are thanking God and praising God, you start to see prophecy among kitchen workers. This is the picture I have in terms of a church, not a people who are just relaxed without fire, without power among the security men. There are people that carry so much fire, when they look at even a person with an evil motive, without saying, who are you? That person, they start to confess already, because they have an irresistible force within them not to come and talk of my leaders and my pastors. Those ones, they are real flames of fire, that they know them anywhere, that anywhere they minister, they ignite the fire of revival. Listen to me, that's the picture among the children. Go to the children's church. As they are singing, you see the Holy Ghost coming down upon those young children. Go to the youth church. As they are just drumming and dancing, you see the power of God slaying them. That's the type of church I want. Not church where you will be doing things, some people are sleeping. It's an abnormality. I pray that fire will come right now in the name of Jesus. That fire will come right now in the name of Jesus. You will catch that fire in the name of Jesus. Rise up to your feet and shout seven amens. Number two. Number three. Number four. Number five. Number six. Number seven. God bless you. When you see Old Path meeting, Old Path revival, you should know that these people, there's no way you get into their midst and you remain cold. Yes, everything they do it with fire and power. They are singing, fire and power. They are teaching, fire and power. Their ministration, fire and power. They are cooking, fire and power. Everything about them, fire and power. And such people, God expects that they don't just have the fire and power, they should talk it far and near. That means anywhere and everywhere they get to, they kindle the fire of revival. I pray after this meeting, as you go back to your locations, as you go back to your churches, as you go back to your environment, those who have known you before, they will see a new pastor. They will see a new leader. They will see a new worker. Yakomo Sekalia Baba Sunday Kalika 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 Grioka Mosekaya. Small prayers, great results. Small prayers, great miracles. That everywhere they will start to call you. That every closed door will become open door. Because revival fire has come. I'm trusting God. All through Plateau State, Nasarawa State, FCT area, any state you come from, Delta, Lagos, that when you go back, the fire of God within you will make you irresistible. Will make you unstoppable. Will make you undeniable. They say, that man, you can't stop him. I've told you about John Vassar. John Vassar was an evangelical soul winner in the 19th century. He does not have place for, you are a sinner. You, Jesus Christ, to save souls. Jesus Christ, we do this. He's so filled with fire, and yet he does not know about the baptism of the Holy Spirit. He's so filled with fire. When he comes to you, he looks you face to face. Repent or you perish. One word, one sentence. You must be born again. Don't gamble with eternity. Just one sentence. And that one sentence will grip the hearts of men. In fact, we were told that there was a time he was in the barracks and he was speaking to 100 souls every day. And when he would be speaking to the 60th soul, it would still be as fresh as when he was speaking to the first soul. And virtually everybody he spoke to would eventually be converted. Revival fire. One day, He was at the lobby of an hotel, and a woman got there, was waiting for the husband, who went to transact some things right inside the hotel. And then when the husband came, said, "Who was that rough man talking to you, disturbing your peace? Why not ask him to mind his business?" Say, "Honey, when you hear him, you will know that it was about his business. When you preach, do they see preaching as your business? When you witness, do they see witnessing as your business? When you pray, do they see praying as your witness? When you teach, do they see teaching as your business? When anything you do, do they see not fire?" And they say, "Ah, Biko, that is his business." When you sing, do they see singing as your business? When you drum with the fire going along with it, do they see it as your business? They say, "Ah, that is his business, so there's no way you could stop him." And that's what it should be when we talk about revival fire. That everything we touch, we have the fire ignited. That people will know that this is different. The God of heaven will cause that era to start in the old part of our commission in the name of Jesus. Let me hear you say good amen. Not just getting old path revival. I want women ministry that is so dynamic and vibrant. In fact, women ministry that will be causing the men to run. When you see women in their manifestations, they say this one's too much. In their prayer meetings, you see signs and wonders going on. That's what it will be. Every section of the church, the men's ministry, in fact, their own. Everybody there is a preacher. Everybody there is a miracle worker. God has brought that season now. And it shall be so in the name of Jesus. Listen to me. That we don't just be bearing a name. Old path revival. Old fashioned revival. Old time revival. Old path revival as out of old. That demonstrates the power as of old. That's exactly what we want. Where everybody is a power carrier, we become terrors to principalities and powers. God's design is that the revival flame should go from city to city, from location to location. The people in every location of all part should not only endeavor to see but how to contact the revival flame, but to see how to take that flame to multitudes. Enough is enough. We have stayed on the mountain of coldness enough. We have stayed on the mountain of expectations enough. Now we have come to the mountain of demonstration. I was at the mountain of demonstration. I can't hear you. Let me hear you say it louder. That's why when you get back to your location, the first person that say, "Pastor, one problem," say, "Just kneel down." Before he finishes, say, "Don't waste time. I have come from the mountain top. And whatever may be the case, I command this your problem to stop now. In the name of Jesus." You say, "Rise up. Your miracle is here." And he said, "Ah, Pastor is different." "Yes. That I'll be expecting your testimony." Before one day, he has come, say, "Pastor, God has done it. God has done it. God has done it." That will be your experience in the name of Jesus. God wants to do great things. The beauty of revival is that it can fast, it can spread very fast. Where you have the right people with the right attitude, yes, the impact can be extraordinary. That's the truth. Revival fire, it has some stupendous results. At the time of the 1928-1930 revival, led by that roller driver, Joseph Ayo Babalola, between 1930 and 1932, all the missionaries in Nigeria, they gathered. They said, with the catalog of things that had happened within streets and cities that had been reached, they said, sir, or young man, he was a young man then, he was just in his 30s, that what God did with you in 3 months, all of us could not do it in 70 years. I am expecting the God of revival to do the same in the Old Path Revival Commission. Remember? Revival, like we know it, in the book of Isaiah, chapter 64. Look at the picture of revival there. Isaiah chapter 64, I read from verse 1. Oh, that thou wouldest rend the heavens, that thou wouldest come down. Shababa. That is it. I see it before revival. The heaven is like a closed heavens. The heaven is like sealed. God seems to be far away. But when revival comes, it's like the heavens are shattered. And Jehovah comes down into the midst of his people. Jehovah comes down into the society. Jehovah comes down with power, fire, fullness, authority, glory. Heaven shout glory. Simply put, some people say revival, a simple definition of revival is God coming down in a new dimension into the midst of people. Simple. God coming down. God coming down in his majesty. God coming down in his might. God coming down in his magnanimity. God coming down in his mercy. God coming down. That means God becomes so close, so near, so real to everybody. That's the beauty of revival. Everybody just, you feel God. The God consciousness will become so real, as if we can touch God. God becomes palpable, or the glory of God almost becomes palpable. You can touch it. That's why, at the time of revival, people cannot continue in sin. That's the truth. Because God has come down. Listen. See Acts of the Apostle, chapter 5, to see a practical picture. At that time, in from verse 1, God came down in judgment. That's the beauty of revival. God comes down to bless, God comes down to judge. Which means, when revival comes, wicked people, witches, wizards, cannot continue indefinitely. They may be coming to give offering. The power of God will slay them, and they will start to confess. Hey, you people pray for me. You people pray for me. You people pray for me. That thing that happened at this time. Daddy, you will do it. You will do it. You will do it. And that speedily, in the name of Jesus. How can revival be there? And you see members of the choir committing immorality. How can there be revival? And you see people committing abortion in the church. How can there be revival? And you see people coming to a meeting and be stealing. They are asked to be paralyzed immediately. Yes. Some of them, God will strike them and they become mental. They start to talk rubbish. That's the beauty of revival. That people cannot continue in sin and they go scot-free. Jehika Jikla Mostaka Gayina Tatu Tatuka. Daddy, release that fire in the midst of the Old Path Revival Commission. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Enough of sinning in the church. Enough of silly behaviors in the church. Enough of sinister attitudes in the church. Enough of backslidings in the church. Enough of making a mockery of God in the church. Look at this. At this time. Verse 10. Then fell she down. God kills. And God will still kill. And fell down straightway at his feet and yielded up the ghost. And the young man came in and bound and found him dead, and carried her forth, buried her by her husband. This is a church. They were not barefoot. They were not astonished. No more say, hey, what happened? No, you can see action. Everybody say action. That's what is called revival, fire action. They are just taking the husband away. You see, when revival fire comes, the young men, the young women, they are all filled with fire. And at times they don't spare even their parents. No room for, you see, people are still gossiping because fire has not come. When you start to gossip, God will bend your mouth. When he bends your mouth to angle 90, or what, which angle is that one? And your mouth goes to one corner. Or you open your mouth, you cannot close it anymore. And say, God, your mouth becomes open. Don't worry, the time has come. Keep on gossiping. But you heard that I've warned you before. Those people, serious, businesslike. That's what a revived church is. No time to say, isn't it? What happened? No way. They knew this woman must have committed sin. This woman must have touched or done what was wrong. No questioning. Say, what happened? Peter, don't kill this one again. You know, it's when there's no revival that people talk carelessly in the church. And I release God's fire and God's power that from today, anybody who talks carelessly in all parts will receive God's judgment. Anybody, male or female, who opens his mouth unguardedly to destroy or disturb the things of God. Jean Kaluska, the God who I've been praying for your revival. Daddy, for over 40 years, I have been crying to you for only one thing. And you assure me that the time is now. I cry to you today, Daddy, that from now onwards, whoever stays in this church to cause confusion with his tongue or with her tongue will receive the judgment that comes with revival. Let me hear you say good amen. Amen. Nobody. Business. Bam. Packed her up like the medical people will say. Business. When revival comes, you don't have time for frivolities. No time for carelessness. I just want to say, yeah, yeah, yeah. Ah. You know what? 3 hours, nobody went to gossip to her. That, have you heard? Peter has killed your husband. Peter. That man. Ordinary fisherman. You know, we talk too much. Ordinary fisherman exalted by God. He was a fisherman, but now an apostle of God. We must now stop all those careless statements, careless descriptions, careless utterances. He might have been an ordinary fisherman, but is now an apostle and a pillar in the church of God. Please, don't use your mouth. Don't dig your grave. They carried him and said, you were husband and wife. You were all together in sin. Be together in the grave and go together to hell. Verse 11. And great fear came upon all the church and upon as many as had these things. And by the hands of the apostles were many signs and wonders wrought. God will wrought signs and wonders through you. It's not because of who they were. It's because of divine timing. which we are getting into now, divine purpose, divine programming, divine design, not because of Alfred Itiowe, not because of 40 years of praying, it's because of God's design. Listen to me. If you have been romancing with occultism, you are still in this church, you better repent. If you have been romancing with evil spirits, you have association with familiar spirits, you better repent. If you are still seeing yourself among your Gbanje people, better go for deliverance. If you still see yourself flying or swimming in the dream, you better go for deliverance, because the days ahead may be too tough for you to handle. Better allow God to take care of you easily. Are there circumstances around your life which you don't understand? Go for deliverance. Let them set you free so that you don't play. Some of you are from the water areas and you have link with water spirits. You better allow yourself to go for deliverance so you can be sanitized, cleansed up. Because the fire coming ahead may bring disgrace and shame. Great signs took place. Verse 13, and the rest, does not no man join himself to them, but the people magnified them. They saw ordinary people who have been honored by God, and people magnified them. Verse 14, and believers were the more added to the Lord, multitudes both of men and women, insomuch that they brought forth the sick into the streets and laid them on beds and couches, that at least the shadow of Peter passing by might overshadow them. Some of them, there came also multitude out of the cities round about unto Jerusalem, bringing sick folks and them which were vexed with unclean spirits, and they were healed, 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 every one of them. That will be our experiences as we leave this meeting in the name of Jesus. God, revival is God coming down to show mercy after a long period of spiritual drought, long period of spiritual dryness, long period of spiritual dross, long period of spiritual driftings, long period of spiritual deteriorations, after long periods of spiritual dullness. In fact, after a long period of spiritual deadness. You know, don't you see what the Lord told the pastor of Sardis? Thou art a name that thou art alive, but thou art dead. There are many pastors who are dead. There's nothing quickening them anymore. There are many archers who are dead. There are many ministers who are dead. You don't see fire around them. But I release fire into your life today. In the name of Jesus. During revival, God comes down. Suddenly, graciously, marvelously. With revival glory, with revival power, causing both personal, congregational, and societal transformation. That's when you know when revival comes. Personal. You see people who have been called before, you start to see personal transformation. In their prayer life, transformation. In their evangelism, transformation. In their walk with God, transformation. In their yieldedness, transformation. In their obedience, transformation. In their consecrations, transformation. In everything, transformation. Is this not Sister Beatrice? Yes, it's Sister Beatrice, but it's a new Sister Beatrice. It's a transformed Sister Beatrice. Is this not Brother Obi? Yes, it's the same Brother Obi, But brother will be with revival fire. Everybody say revival fire. That fire will affect personal life, family life, congregational life, and societal life. In Psalm 85, I read from verse 3. Psalm 85, reading from verse 3. See what it says about God coming down. Thou hast taken away all thy wrath. Thou hast turned thyself from the fierceness of thy anger. You see, before revival, it's like God is angry with us. We pray. Our mouths are almost peeling. Nothing is happening. We fast. We are almost having ulcer. Nothing is happening. Night vigil, until we become very lean. Nothing is happening. As if God, what is happening? But I prophesy, from now onwards, your night vigil will be filled with fire. Your prayer meeting will be filled with power. Your amen is not convincing. I say your night vigil will be filled with power. Yeah. 45%. I say from now onwards, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the very Lord of the church, from now onwards, your prayer life, your night vigil will be filled with power. God bless you. You see the difference? That's what it should be. That people say, what is happening? Yes, fire. You know, when the cloven tongues came like as of fire, people were running. Hey, what is happening? Is this place burning? And when they came, the way they saw them under the unction of the Holy Ghost, they said, these people are drunk. Oh, not drunken with wine, drunken with power. And that's what it should be. Everything we do, they say, these people are filled with new wine. Says verse 4, turn us, O God of our salvation, cause thine anger towards us to cease. Will thou be angry with us forever? Will thou draw out thine anger to all generations? Will thou not revive us again, that thy people may rejoice in thee? Not rejoicing in the houses we build. Not rejoicing in the cars. We may not have cars. We may not even have promotions. But we see people. Like I said, revival comes with people becoming God-centered, God-conscious. Everything God. For me to live is Christ. To die is gain. I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live. The life that I now live, I live by the faith of the Son of God. Everybody, you don't see us carrying God. Eh? Everywhere, we are carrying God anywhere and everywhere. To the offices, God. In the taxi, God. In the planes, God. In the buses, God. In the farm, God. Anywhere in the villages, God. People are rejoicing. You see us singing. It will just be great song. As you are singing, witches and wizards are running away. Even in your father's compound, you are coming like this. Ah, Antia Da is coming. All those evil people, they are taking cover. I remember in those days, around that same time, there's one of those people, Ba Odushono. They call him Ekun Okwaje. That means somebody who behaves like a tiger and is the Lord over witches. The moment his vehicle, his motorcycle, lands in the village about 1 mile away, they say, he's coming. They will be running into the inner land. Yes, he has not reached there. Not for you now. Witches will be rubbing shoulders with you. Witches will be sleeping on the same bed with you. Everybody say, God forbid, in the name of Jesus. Akasimba. I thought we rise up and with hellfire say, God forbid, no more. Again? Again. One more time. Shlamboska. That's it. I release special fire upon these people for tonight. Holy Ghost fire. Come upon this congregation now. That anywhere they get to, there will be terrors to principalities and powers. It shall be so in the name of for the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. You must be different. Witches and wizards, you'll be afraid to shake your hands. You want to shake their hands? They know that when you shake their hands, they will receive Holy Ghost shock. Huh? Because they could look past skin there. Something must move from you into them. Has God changed? This must be different from today. Change your perspective. No more running away. If somebody is becoming uncomfortable where you are living, let him pack away. The witches must pack away. If you are not careful, let your landlord pack away from you. Yes, so he's the builder of the house. But he comes, the moment you are coming, his heart is beating. This church man is coming. And you are coming. I say, Holy Ghost, fire, fire, fall. And you are just singing, rejoicing. You don't even have a bicycle. Not only. And the man's heart is. Great things will start to happen after this meeting. It will be so. It will be so. Enough is enough of ordinary lifestyles. If this is revival commission, the revival must spread in the name of Jesus. I've told you of my experience, I think 1971. I was not yet born again. But all the while, I'd been fasting and very prayerful. I could fast for even those days as a sinner, 45 days, seven, not six to six. Six to seven. And I will pray. So somehow I carry an aura with me. I remember this man so well. I don't want to mention his name. In front of the typing pool, I was coming like this. He was coming like this. He was quite older, but he was very immoral. Very immoral. They say he grew up in Ghana. He was just finishing all those young girls. It was a secondary school. Me, I was just coming my own way. As we got there, good afternoon, Mr. So-and-so. He was shocked. He didn't know when he said, Mr. Itiowe, anytime I see you, I used to be afraid. I was not a believer. I was not born again. In fact, one of the oldest man then had to see me. I said, sir, this is what Mr. So-and-so said. He said, Alfred, be careful of that man. Unbeliever, from today, you will carry fire. Yeah. I said, from today, anywhere you go, you will carry. Why should be? Listen to me. When the fire of God comes, they say, unbeliever is raping a Christian, it should not be able to come near you. When he wants to come close and he says, yeah, fire, you will not even pray. He can't come close to you. It should not be able to come close to you if you are what you ought to be. Who is that rapist? Who is that evildoer? They should not be able to come near your vicinity at all. I remember one of our sisters in those days, she got converted from the other religion. And they came sometime, they wanted to bind her, this God. And they were coming close. They saw fire all around her. They couldn't come close. Both things, both fire and serpent. Who want to come close to serpent? And nobody told them, they ran away. Every enemy will run away from you. Every evil doer will run away from you. So, verse 7. Show us thy mercy, O Lord, and grant us thy salvation. That's what comes in with revival. Mercy. You yourself too, you become surprised as to what God is doing. You just know that it's not because of you. That's why at such a time everyone becomes very careful, because you just see God do some things. A little pronouncement, it comes to pass. A little judgment, God executes it. And that's the time that everybody wants to be very careful. As revival comes, all these people have a sense of genuine forgiveness, genuine grace, genuine ownership of the Almighty God. When revival comes, you see supernatural turnarounds in lives, in lands, and in situations. And that is what God wants to do again. No one would want to cover the fire of revival. Like I said, at the time of the Nigerian revivals, you see that it spread very easily. In those days, kings, they would vacate their palaces for the revivalists. They were the people begging, please come from Ghana, from Cross River, from all over. Come, please. These were people who probably could not speak English. Even from England, they were begging revivalists, come to our land, come to our land. Don't you hear? Even the time of Paul, come over to Macedonia and help us. As you go back, really must cover and release the anointing upon you, that people will start to seek for you. They will want you in their meetings, in their environments. They will want you in the name of Jesus. And in the 70s, when we believed, yeah, the 70s, you just see the things were moving. You see, nobody was begging people. Everyone wanted to go out, both male and female. I was a missions director. First of all, I had gone to Burkina Faso, Upper Volta then, as a missions man. I left school. I said, souls were perishing. Our priority now is to revive lands and lives. When I came back to set up the missions office, most of our missionaries, women, they went to terrible places. The Gambia, Lesotho, tough lands. And they were causing waves. People were seeking, send us men, send us men. And right within the country, people will forsake their jobs, well-paying jobs. All they wanted was going around to carry the revival fire. People went along to Edo State, to Ondo State, to Kwara State, to different places. That was when mommy had to leave her well-paying job. Mommy, as a bilingual secretary, trained from France, was any much more than a graduate. She had to forsake that to go to Togo, to go and start a work, a difficult land. Men, they didn't, because it was a socialist nation. So what I'm saying, when there's revival fire, people were moving. And they say, you young lady, you will waste your life here. All these people could not do it. They pay you. Like the scripture, you know, they could not do it. Say, if the life is wasted, let it be wasted for God. But thank God, most of the work going on in the Francophone country today, she laid the foundation. What will be said about you? What will be said about you? What will be said about you? That's the truth. Those people, they fought a good fight. They finished their faith. They kept their course. Did all that God wanted her to do. According to divine, what God said, that she did all I wanted her to do. He had finished her race. Let her not just be here suffering. Let me bring her to her reward. She was a tremendous woman. I saw her photograph some day. I said, thank God for you. Yes, I was saying, my heart, thank God for you. You have graduated. I'm still struggling. That you are a graduate already. You are there. I said, thank God for you. Probably yesterday or 2 days ago. I said, thank God for you. You have graduated. Me, I'm here. I'm still struggling. All I'm trying to say, at the time of revival, People never cared. Will they get married? That was not their priority. When revival fire comes, all those things were not your power. Husband, wife, well, it's through education, no certificate. When revival fire comes, it doesn't, all those things don't bother you. But do you know what? God will eventually bring everything. Huh? God will give you much more than your expectations. That is the truth. That's God. God will never owe anybody. That's why I pity some of you. What are you using your life for? What is going to be your story? You never knew that she was going to marry a pastor. All she wants, let me lose my life for Christ. And in those days, I was pitying them. Hey, these young sisters, how will they get? I was praying that God will have mercy on them. They were three. They were all married to pastors. Yes, three of them. She was leaving them. Their room was their office. I remember when I got there first, I was on my own way to Upper Volta on Mission Store. I saw where she wrote, she pinched it on her, by her bedside. Galatians 2 verse 18. If I build again, the things I want destroyed, I make myself a transgressor. Hey, I said, these sisters are serious. So, me, you know, though going but with a critical mind, are these sisters very serious? Do they know standards? Do they keep to standards? I was watching everything. You know, my critical mindset. They were just lost. And God showed all of them mercy. You see, young people, come to a point that you are ready to spend and be spent for Christ. Today, many of us, we are too conscious about our lives. We are too conscious about ourselves. We are too conscious about things. Live your life for God. And God will surprise you. Let be a man for revival. I've told you all my story. Myself and Pastor Charles, we were living together. We even said we were not going to marry. He was a good cook. He said he has PhD tomato. I said, you just be cooking. Then let us be enjoying. We sew the same type of dress in those days. In the morning we were. That was how we were living. Evangelism. I remember I would be ironing. I said, God, please, I want you to use me. I didn't know, not for full time, but I just want you to use me. Some people say God wants to use them, they are running. I say, God, me, I will not run away. Oh, I never knew I would want the BAs. I want to say, God, I love you. I want you to use me. When we leave, I'm leaving home in the morning, we will not see again until very late in the night. As he was walking on Victoria and Island, from there he will go to our papa for evangelism. That's the way we lead our lives. Get to Lawanson, we jump into the buses with our buses, our bus filled with tracks. Everything was the work for God. Work for God. What do you want to do with your life? Life is going. Nobody's getting younger. But what story will you say about how you lived your life for God? What legacy will your children learn from you to say, this man, our daddy, was a man sold out to God. When I was talking about holy house, only for the Lord, I said, as that are totally sold out. Everything is God. Everything is God. That was the way we lived. God, 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 God. I told you about my mobile house. I have everything, as all compartments, boiler ring, everything. Anywhere I saw, I slept. So my ruggedness is not now. Anywhere. I could sleep on my knees. I could sleep on ordinary ground. Even now, I could sleep on ordinary ground without a mattress. I've so trained up myself into ruggedness. For 7 hours night vigil, I will not sit down. I said, I never knew where God was taking me to. You see, I have a life on legacy. I was all the while, I never knew I was going to missions, picturing that Paul must be a rugged person. And that time, myself and the just pastor now, Pastor Lorede, we were. He had a motorcycle. He was my motorcycle driver. You know, I used to have many drivers. So, anyway, Brother Joseph, let's go. Let's go. That's your pastor. Business. In those days, anywhere we could go from Lagos, we could go to anywhere we're going. I love those type of rugged lives. He will buy a motorcycle jacket. He will buy one for himself. He will buy one for me. That's the way he lived. He will buy a book for himself. He will buy my own also. We at least, God had been doing things. So they are not new things. So, but his motorcycle, it's quite older. But anyway, he's ready to carry me. I love such rugged lifestyle. Not that there was no cow, I still prefer to go on motorcycle. This is my picture of a rugged life. A life. In those days, I would leave Lagos in the night, get to Enugu here. From Enugu, I would go to Oweri. From Oweri, I may go to Kaduna. Brethren, he that loses his life for him will gain it. Reviver. And God wants you to get into this issue of revival. I don't have much time, but let me just read this passage. The time is fast spent. Look at Acts of the Apostle, chapter 8. Acts chapter 8, look at verse 5. Then Philip went down to the city of Samaria and preached Christ unto them. And the people with one accord gave heed unto those things which Philip spake, hearing and seeing the miracles which he did. For unclean spirits, crying with loud voice, came out of many that were possessed with them, and many taken with palsies, and that were lame were healed. And there was a great joy in that city. But there was a certain man called Simon, which before time in the same city used sorcery and bewitched the people of Samaria, giving out that himself was some great one, to whom they all gave heed, from the least to the greatest, saying, this man is the great power of God. And to him they had regard, because that of long time he had bewitched them with sorceries. But when they believed Philip preaching the things concerning the kingdom of God and the name of Jesus Christ, they were baptized, both men and women. Then Simon himself believed also. When he was baptized, he continued with Philip and wondered, beholding the miracles and signs which were done. We see an individual taking the revival flame to a whole city. Listen, the text shows the persons for revival, the power of revival, the purpose of revival. The ordinary people, Philip was to be a food server, a deacon. That means God does not need any special person. Joseph Alola was not an evangelist, he was a roller driver with PWD. All these people, what do you call roller driver? That thing, is it? They used to, what do they call that thing they use for the road? When you are making a road, roller, that's what he was driving. So it was not anything, he was in the Anglican church, he was not in a Pentecostal church, but God used him. And God is going to use you in Jesus' name. Listen to me. Seven things, then I will pray. Number one, God usually is the main usually is the main source of revival at any given time. Revival starts with God, continues with God, and ends with God. The moment God is taken away, revival ends. Then at times, God raises up a person as like the key figure. We've been talking about Babalola. We've been talking about other people. This time, at this revival, God raised up Philip, and God is raising you up where you are in Jesus' name. Listen to me. Number three, revival fire from one person can affect a whole community, a whole city, a whole nation, and a whole generation. Number four, the new revival fire spreads quickly and brightly. Five, revival fire brings fresh glory to God and good to humanity. Number six, revival fire brings speedy and noticeable restoration to lives and land. Restoration of the glory of God. Restoration of the power of God. Don't you see? Before this time, they have been having a fake power. Simon the sorcerer was just deceiving the people. But now, they saw a power which was above all powers. And revival fire affects not only lives, it affects the lands. Number seven, revival fire comes with divine presence. Yes, and divine and gracious manifestations. Look at joy, evil spirits crying out. Revival fire generally brings gladness and joy to multitudes. I pray that will be our experiences in Jesus' name. What are revival manifestations? When revival comes, you see unusual power of God in manifestation. Number two, unusual presence of God is carried by old and young. Number three, you see unusual preachings of the world. You see Christ coming back. Unusual plundering of hell. Unusual populating of heaven. Unusual projection of the kingdom. And unusual possibilities, even through unrecognized people. Satanic coverings over lands will be broken. There will be mass deliverance, mass repentance, mass returning to the Lord, mass reconciliations, mass rejoicing, mass receiving of blessings, mass restorations. Restoration of the word of the true word of God. Restoration of the true ways of God. Restoration of true worship. Restoration of the true walking of the Holy Spirit. Restoration of the true warnings of God. Restoration of people living in the way of God. And the fruit of revival is usually very stable, solid, steadfast, and serious. I don't have time. Go through Acts of the Apostle, Acts chapter 2, Acts chapter 4, Acts chapter 3, Acts chapter 6. You see the fruit of revival. Let me just say this before we pray about revival message. It's very important. There's one thing you see that is restored. Acts of the Apostle, chapter 8, C, verse 5. Then Philip went down to the city of Samaria and preached Christ unto them. You see, the revival message is centered mainly on Christ. Not even on healing, not on deliverance, not even on miracle. Revival message centers on Christ. Not Christ and the revivalist. Not Christ and holy water. Not Christ and olive oil. These are some things that destroyed revival. Not Christ and beggarly issues. Listen to me. It's Christ and Christ alone. In fact, Jesus is preached as not only the Messiah, he's preached as our model. He's preached as our master. He's preached as the mark of all believers. Jesus and him crucified. Jesus is presented in his total simplicity. But beyond that, in his total sufficiency. sufficient for all problems, sufficient for all puzzles, sufficient for all plight, sufficient to handle all predicaments, sufficient to bring down principalities. Jesus. Everyone say Jesus. Again. Say it louder. And you see God's design. After some time, God said, Philip, move to Gaza. Gaza. He wants you to move. And from there, that's how he started spreading. You see, God wants the revival fire to spread. From there, he went to Ethiopia, and the glory is there. God is going to use you. Say, God will use me. If you believe that God will use you, stand up and shout it three times. God will use me. Number two. Number three. Give God a wave offering. Naga Siba start to speak in tongues. Balika Bababuskanda Toto. Papa Bronish Kandachkados Kadede. Yayaka Yayaka. Malika Maloko Seka. Bronika da Punya. Bonika 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 Bonika. Irila Kadishka. Joka da 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 manika. Ah, biko biko biko. Open your mouth. Rila, 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 rila. Grianina.